ಜ್ಞಾನಕೋಶ ಮಹಾಭಾರತ
ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್. ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್.
The Mahabharata is an epic narrative of the Kurukshetra war and the fates of the Kaurava and the Pandava princes. It also contains philosophical and devotional material, such as a discussion of the four goals of life or Purusharthas. Among the principal works and stories in the Mahabharata are the Bhagavad Gita, the story of Damayanti, an abbreviated version of the Ramayana, and the Rishyasringa, often considered as works in their own right. Traditionally, the authorship of the Mahabharata is attributed to Vyasa. There have been many attempts to unravel its historical growth and compositional layers. The oldest preserved parts of the text are thought to be not much older than around 400 BCE, though the origins of the epic probably fall between the 8th and 9th centuries BCE. The text probably reached its final form by the early Gupta period, that is the 4th century CE. The title may be translated as the Great Tale of the Bharata Dynasty. According to the Mahabharata itself, the tale is extended from a shorter version of 24,000 verses called simply Bharata. The Mahabharata is the longest known epic poem and has been described as the longest poem ever written. Its longest version consists of over 1 lakh sloka or over 2 lakh individual verses lines. Each sloka is a couplet and long prose passage. About 1.8 million words in total, the Mahabharata is roughly 10 times the length of the Iliad and the Odyssey combined, or about 4 times the length of the Ramayana. Mahabharata story. The word Bharata, Bharata, refers to the battle of the Bharatas. The epic Mahabharata is one of the largest poems in the world and is divided into 18 sections, parvas. It is looked upon as the Panchama Veda, the fifth Veda, as it contains all that is said in the Veda. Vyasa and Ganesha wrote Mahabharata. Once Vyasa was thinking how to teach his disciples Mahabharata, which he just then conceived, Lord Brahma suggested to take help from Lord Ganesha. Lord Ganesha agreed but asked Vyasa not to stop till it is over, and Vyasa put the condition that no word must be written without understanding. The entire story is composed in 1 lakh verses. In the invocatory verse of Mahabharata is referred as Jaya. Then number 18 represents Jaya, success, and the 18th chaptered Mahabharata is known as Jayashastra. It has 18 chapters. The war was fought for 18 days. It had 18 units of army, and Bhagavad Gita has 18 chapters. Veda Vyasa or Krishna Dvaipayana. He is the author of Mahabharata and considered to be the scribe of the Vedas and Puranas. He is considered as an avatar of Vishnu. Vyasa is also considered to be one of the seven Charanjeevans. The festival of Guru Purnima or Vyasa Purnima is his birthday and also the day he divided the Vedas. He was the son of Satyavati, daughter of a ferryman or fisherman, and the wandering sage Parashara. He was born on an island in the river Yamuna. The place is named after him as Vedavyas. He was dark complexioned and hence called by the name Krishna, black, and also the name Dvaipayana, meaning island born. Vyasa was grandfather of the Kauravas and Pandavas. Their fathers, Dhritarashtra and Pandu, adopted as the sons of Vichitra Virya by the royal family, were fathered by him. He had a third son, Vidura, by a serving maid. He has another son called Sukhadev. Hindus traditionally hold that Vyasa categorized the primordial single Veda into four. Hence he was called Veda Vyasa, or splinter of the Vedas. The splitting being a feat that allowed people to understand the divine knowledge of the Veda. The word Vyasa means split, differentiate, or describe. It has been debated whether Vyasa was a single person or a class of scholars who did the splitting. The Vishnu Purana has a theory about Vyasa. The Hindu view of the universe is that of a cyclic phenomenon that comes into existence and dissolves repeatedly. Each cycle is presided over by a number of Manus, one for each Manvantara, that has four ages, yugas of declining virtues. The Dwapara Yuga is the third Yuga. In every third world age, Dwapara, Vishnu in the person of Vyasa, in order to promote the good of mankind, divides the Veda, which is properly but one, into many portions. Observing the limited perseverance, energy and application of mortals, he makes the Veda fourfold to adapt it to their capacities and the bodily form which he assumed in order to effect that classification is known by the name of Vedavyasa. 28 times have the Vedas been arranged by the great rishis in the Vaivasvanta Manvantara, and consequently 8 and 20 Vyasas have passed away, by whom in the respective period the Veda has been divided into four. The first distribution was made by Swayambhu Brahma himself. In the second, the arranger of the Veda Vyasa was Prajapati, and so on up to 28.
Mahabharata Parvas. There are 18 Parvas. The first Parva is Adi Parva, the book of beginning. Second is Sabha Parva, the book of assembly hall. Maya Danava erects the palace and court Sabha at Indraprastha. Life at the court, Yudhishthira's Rajasuya Yajna, the game of dice, and the eventual exile of the Pandavas. The third one is Vana Parva, also Aranyaka Parva. Aranyaka Parva, the book of the forest, the 12 years of exile in the forest, Aranyaka. Virata Parva, the book of Virata, the year in ignominy spent at the court of Virata. Udyoga Parva, the book of the effort, preparations for war and efforts to bring about peace between the Kauravas and the Pandavas, which eventually failed. Udyoga means effort or work. Bhishma Parva, the book of Bhishma, the first part of the great battle with Bhishma as commander for the Kauravas and his fall on the bed of arrows. Drona Parva, the book of Drona, the battle continues with Drona as commander. This is the major book of the war. Most of the great warriors on both sides are dead by the end of this book. Karna Parva, the book of Karna, the battle again with Karna as commander. Shalya Parva, the book of Shalya, the last day of the battle with Shalya as commander.
also told in detail is the pilgrimage of Balarama to the forks of the river Saraswati and the mace fight between Bhima and Duryodhana, which ends the war since Bhima kills Duryodhana by smashing him on the thighs with a mace. Sauptika Parva, the book of sleeping warrior. Ashwatthama, Kripa and Kritavarma kills the remaining Pandava army in their sleep. Only 7 warriors remain on the Pandava side and 3 on the Kaurava side. Stree Parva, the book of the women. Gandhari, Kunti and the women, three of the Kauravas and Pandavas, lament the dead. Shanti Parva, the book of peace. The crowning of Yudhishthira as king of Hastinapura and instructions from Bhishma for the newly anointed king on society, economics and politics. This is the longest book of the Mahabharata. Shanti means peace. Anushasan Parva, the book of the instructions. The final instructions, Anushasana, from Bhishma. Ashwamedhika Parva, the book of the horse sacrifice. The royal ceremony of the Ashwamedha, horse sacrifice, conducted by Yudhishthira. The world conquest by Arjuna, the Anugita, is told by Krishna to Arjuna. Ashwamedhika Parva, the book of the hermitage. Ashramavashika Parva, the eventual deaths of Dhritarashtra, Gandhari and Kunti in a forest fire when they are living in a hermitage in the Himalayas. Vidura predeceases them and Sanjaya on Dhritarashtra's building goes to live in the higher Himalayas, bidding. Mausalya Parva, the book of the clubs. The infighting between the Yadavas with maces, Mausala, and the eventual destruction of the Yadavas. Mahaprasthanika Parva, the book of the great journey. The great journey of Yudhishthira and his brothers across the whole country and finally their ascent of the great Himalayas, where each Pandava falls except for Yudhishthira. Swargarohana Parva, the book of the ascent to heaven. Yudhishthira's final test and the return of the Pandavas to the spiritual world, Swarga. Harivamsa Parva, this book of the genealogy of Hari, is also included towards the end.
ಜ್ಞಾನಕೋಶ ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ಆದಿಪರ್ವ
ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್.
ಆದಿಪರ್ವ. ಓಂ. ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಬೋಡ್ ಡೌನ್ ಟು ನಾರಾಯಣ ಅಂಡ್ ನರ, ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಲ್ಟೆಡ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟು ದ ಗಾಡೆಸ್ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ, ಮಸ್ಟ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಜಯಾ ಬಿ ಅಟರ್ಡ್. Ugrashrava, the son of Lomaharshana, surnamed Sauti, well versed in the Puranas, bending with humility, one day approached the great sages of rigid woes, sitting at their ease, who had attended the 12 years' sacrifice of Saunaka, surnamed Kulapati, in the forest of Naimisha, accomplished in speech, Sauti, thus questioned, gave in the midst of that big assemblage of contemplative munis a full and proper answer in words consonant with their mode of life. Sauti said, having heard the diverse sacred and wonderful stories which were composed in his Mahabharata by Krishna Dvaipayana and which were recited in full by Vaisapanya at the snake sacrifice of the high-souled royal sage Janmejaya and in the presence also of the chief of princes, the son of Parikshit, and having wondered about visiting many sacred waters and holy shrine, I journeyed to the country venerated by the Dvijas, that is twice born, and called Samantapaneksha, where formerly was fought the battle between the children of Kuru and Pandu, and all the chiefs of the land ranged on their side. Thence, anxious to see you, I am come into your presence, a revered sages, all of whom are to be as Brahma, a greatly blessed who shine in this place of sacrifice with the splendor of the solar fire, ye who have concluded the silent meditation and have fed the holy fire, and yet who are sitting without care, O ye Dvijas, shall I repeat, shall I recount the sacred stories collected in the Purana containing precepts of religious duty and of worldly profit, or the acts of illustrious saints and sovereign mankind? The Rishi replied, the Purana first promulgated by the great Rishi Dvaipayana, and which after having been heard both by the gods and Brahma Rishi, he was highly esteemed, being the most eminent narrative that exists, diversified both in diction and division, possessing subtle meanings logically combined and gleaned from the Vedas, is a sacred work. Composed in elegant language, it includeth the subjects of the other books. It is elucidated by other sastras and comprehendeth the sense of the four Vedas. We are desirous of hearing that history also called Bharata, the holy composition of the wonderful Vyasa, which dispelleth the fear of evil, just as it was cheerfully recited by the Rishi Vaisapayana under the direction of Dvaipayana himself at the snake sacrifice of the Raja Janmejaya. Jnanakosha, Mahabharata. Adi Parva.
Narayanam namaskritya naranchiva narottamam devim sarasvatim vyasam tato jayamudirayet.
Janmejaya was a Kuru king. He was the son of Parikshit and Madravati. He was the grandson of Abhimanyu and the great grandson of Arjuna. He was ascended to the Kuru throne following the death of his father. His significance comes as the listener of the first narration of the Mahabharata, narrated by Vaisapayana, pupil of Vyasa. There was a dispute between him and Vaisampayana. Possibly as its aftermath, he abdicated and his son, Santanika, succeeded him. His priest, Thura Kaveshya, anointed him with the great anointing of Indra. He performed a Ashwamedha Yajna at a place named Ashwadhitva, and the priest who performed it for him was Indro the Daivapa Shaunuka. Janmejaya had six able brothers, Kakashsena, Ugrasena, Chitrasena, Indrasena, Shushesena, and Nakshasena. He wanted to exterminate the race of Nagas since Takshaka was responsible for the death of his father, Parikshit. Emperor Janmejaya was responsible for the retelling of the famous epic Mahabharata, a story of Janmejaya's ancestors from the time of Bharata up to the great Kurukshetra war between his great-grandfathers, the Pandavas, and their paternal cousins, the Kauravas. It was recited to Janmejaya at the Sarpa Sastra snake sacrifice by the sage Vaisampayana, to whom it had been imparted by his preceptor Vedavyasa, after he asked Vaisampayana about his ancestors. At the snake sastra, a learned sage named Astika, a boy in age, came and interfered. His mother, Manasa, was a Naga and father was a Brahmin. Janmejaya had to listen to the words of the learned Astika and set Takshaka free. He also stopped the massacre of the Nagas and ended all the enmity with them. From then onward, the Nagas and Kurus lived in peace. Family tree of the Kuru dynasty. Kuru, the ancestors, after six generations, a Dasa, a fisherman's daughter, Satyavati, and Satyavati married the saint Parasara, who had the king Santanu, and Santanu married Ganga and had children, and who only living child was Bhishma. Satyavati also had a son called Vyasa, and he is the composer of Mahabharata. King Santanu had the son with Satyavati as Vichitravirya, and Vichitravirya married Ambika and Ambalika but had no children, and on the advice of Vyasa they got children, and thus they have become Kauravas and Pandavas. Adi Parva. King Pratipa belonged to Lunar dynasty and he ruled Hastinapur. Once Ganga emerged as beautiful maiden and requested him to marry. He refused but promised her to marry his son Santanu. They had a son named Devavrata. Once Santanu saw Satyavati, the daughter of a fisherman. He wanted to marry her, but her father posed a condition that only her son would rule the kingdom, but it was not accepted to him. Devavrata went to Satyavati's father and promised him that he would never marry in his life and maintain lifelong celibacy for the sake of his father. The celestials and others applauded at the promise and called him Bhishma and his vow as Bhishma Pratigya. Bhishma Bhishma. Bhishma was the grandfather of both the Pandavas and the Kauravas. Once the eighth Vasu visited Vasistha's ashram and accompanied by their wives, Prabhasa stole the cow and cursed by Vasistha to be born in the world of men. It was this Prabhasa who took birth as Devavrata Bhishma. Bhishma was born as the youngest son of the illustrious king Santanu and Ganga. Santanu silently bore the torture of watching his wife drown his offspring 7 times. When Ganga was about to drown Bhishma, Santanu protested. She left Santanu promising to return the child to him once he is grown up. During his time with his mother, Bhishma learned political science from Brihaspati, the Vedas and Vedangas from Vasistha, and archery from Parashurama. He was known as Bhishma Pitamaha. Bhishma means taking a terrible oath, referring to his oath of lifelong celibacy. Santanu wanted to marry Satyavati. Her father wanted her child to become the ruler after Santanu. Devavrata then took the terrible oath of lifelong celibacy, thus sacrificing his crown prince title and denying himself the pleasures of intercourse. This gave him immediate recognition among the gods, and his father granted him the boon of Swachanda Mrityu. Bhishma also took another oath shortly after the marriage of Santanu and Satyavati. Bhishma vowed he would see his father's image in whoever sat on the throne of Hastinapur and would serve him without question. This woe ended up being the main cause of his problems. As a result, Bhishma was forced to comply with all of Dhritarashtra's orders, no matter what injustice was done to the Pandavas. Bhishma was a great archer and a warrior. For Vichitra Virya, Bhishma cleverly abducted princess Amba, Ambika and Ambalika of Kashi. Amba, humiliated and enraged beyond measure, vowed to avenge herself against Bhishma, even if it meant being reborn over and over again. Amba sought refuge with Parashurama, who ordered Bhishma to marry Amba. Amba reborn as the Yonch prince Shikhandi in the household of King Drupada to take revenge. Bhishma died after the age of 350 years. Bhishma was a great warrior and a wonderful personality. Arjuna took help and using Shikhandi as a shield, he shot at Bhishma, piercing his entire body. Bhishma gave up the fight, focusing his life force and breath, auspicious moment to give up his body.